special game, but I'm not a piece of me. Stimulate my brain, oh. So come on, baby, won't you show some class? Why'd you have to move so fast? We don't have to take our clothes off to have a good time. Oh. Drink some cherry wine, oh, oh. Just slow down. You want me? A man wants to be approached coolly, romantically, oh. So come on, baby, won't you show some class? Why'd you have to move so fast?
Fantastic. And you know what I love about you is you take risks. And I know we hear that a lot on this show, but, you know, to do that song in that style, you know, when you've got this one shot on a live semi-final, it was fantastic. I think your voice, you really sound like a recording artist. So I feel very proud, very happy, and actually quite smug right now.
Oh, God.
I hate to say it, Simon, but I have to doff my proverbial cap to you. I think you have found someone who could have success around the world.
Would you
be on this show? I would evade, and I would ovulate if I saw him.
Callum, you know what? If you've got it, you've just got it, and you are just one of those people. You're a natural born performer, and your voice is super sexy. Oh. And that, trust me, the girls will love it. Beautiful, beautiful version. Fantastic. Love you.
It was such a brilliant song choice. Yeah. I mean, just so clever. Yeah. And as everyone's, you know, said in various ways, you have such an authentic voice. But best of all, you are lovely. And everything about you comes out. You know, you just feel very, very real. So well done. That was fabulous.
There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. Oh, I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mile, swim every ocean, just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
Ladies and gentlemen, Musa.
My hands shaking, and you are the reason. Oh, my heart keeps bleeding, and I need you now.
Oh, if I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every hour of every day keeping you safe. And I'd climb every mountain, and I'd swim every ocean, just to be
wait to hear if you've won BGT. What do you want to say to Musa tonight?
I mean, what I want to say to Musa is you are such an inspiration. You're so incredible. It is a pleasure and an honor to share the stage with you. And this is just the beginning. It doesn't matter what the result is for you, you are going to be a superstar.
And Musa, how was it taking the stage with a Got Talent legend?
Wow, it's such an honor, you know, like I couldn't believe when I was told that I'm going to perform with him. And today I'm so excited. I was like, this is a dream come true, and I'm really honored. Thank you so much.
Well, good luck tonight, Musa.
What's your name?
My name's Lauren.
And where are you from?
From Brooklyn, New York.
Is that right?
Yes.
So why Britain's Got Talent?
Most of my favorite singers are from the UK, so I thought I'd come pay a visit to you guys.
Okay, so Lauren, tell me a bit about you.
I think some of you guys have actually heard my voice, but you don't know my face. I sang the song Never Enough on The Greatest Showman.
Oh, oh my God!
Oh my God! Blew their minds!
Oh my God!
So I was hired to do the reference vocals for the actresses so they could learn the songs. And so they had me come in and sing Never Enough. And it really was Rebecca Ferguson, who plays Jenny Lind, who said, I think that Lauren should sing the song, and I'll lip sync.
So you sang one of the biggest songs of all time. You've now revealed it wasn't the actress who sang the song in the movie. It was you singing that song. So why didn't you get that big deal after the song?
I was more comfortable singing behind the scenes, but I feel kind of like the song was meant for me, and I'm kind of ready to put a face to the song. So I'm here to do that.
Are you going to sing that tonight?
Yes.
Such a great thing to watch.
Good luck.
Here we go. Breathe, girl.
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way, can't let this moment end. I set off a dream in me,
getting louder now. Can you hear it echoing? Take my hand. Will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough, never be enough.
You've got to start an ovation already.
I am absolutely shaking. I can't believe I've had this incredible opportunity to give you your moment to shine, because this is it.
We were just in palm of your hand from like the first note. I can't think there's been many experiences on the show where we've ever had that feeling.
Well, it feels like a superstar's arrived. Like it transcended, it was otherworldly.
The
this is so well deserved, because seeing somebody else sing that song in that movie and not have the recognition of doing one of the most incredible vocals ever, and now for you to kind of reveal yourself to the world, it was actually one of the most incredible audition moments I've ever experienced. I'm speechless.
Thank you.
I'm so happy for you. Timing in life is everything, and maybe this is your moment now. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was what I call a masterclass.
Thank you, Simon.
That's how you do it.
Heidi.
I think I can speak for everyone in this room, but you were giving us all the feels.
Ooh.
I mean, and you just sounded just so beautiful.
Mel B.
You have a voice that is just to die for, literally. I mean, you could sing absolutely anything, which is actually my point. Because I think if I was your mentor, I would have chosen a different song, because you could have had everybody in this audience crying.
What, like Wannabe?
Howie, let's move on.
Good God, there's not much left in this.
Howie!
It's up to the audience. They can only pick one, but I loved it. America's gonna love it. You're amazing.
Thank you, Howie.
Lauren's fate now lies with the audience voters. One more time for Lauren Allred.
Hello.
Hello.
What are your names?
My name is Billy, and this is my sister, Emily.
Oh, fantastic. So how long have you known each other? So, Billy and Emily. How old are you guys?
I'm 28 and she's 25.
Take it away, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
on earth is going to happen now?
Say live and let die.
Like, I was so worried for your head. You're fearless and like a fresh spin on roller skating. I thought it was fantastic.
Felt dangerous and fresh. So I congratulate you for winning something so exciting to roller skating and to Britain's Got Talent.
And you know, I've seen a lot of roller skating acts on this show. Normally they are horrific because you kind of think, what can you do on a stage of roller skates? I've actually never seen an act like that in my life. I mean, it's incredible. Really incredible.
I'm going to kick this off with a big, fat yes.
Thank you.
A very, very easy yes. Well done.
Massive yes from me.
It's a big, fat yes.
Emily.
Hello.
How are you?
Very well.
Good.
Very excited.
You look a little bit nervous.
Yes, we are putting a lot on the line tonight, so the nerves are there, but it's all good.
Good. Good luck.
Thank you.
Now you're going to see men three.
Here we go, guys, clearing stage.
They better be good. You've coached them.
Let's give it one more. Let's give it one more. We're pushing past the heartbeat.
heaven on my heart. You can love me.
Whoa. My God. I honestly feel this is what the show is all about.
Simon's very lucky to have you in his squad. I gotta say that. This is one of the most dangerous, exciting, standout acts we've ever had in Got Talent history.
Thank you. Thank you.
Can I just say, this was spectacular. It really, really was. You really like this act, don't you?
Like them? I love them.
But you know what? Guess who has the golden buzzer tonight?
No, you can't.
I guess that helps the Mel B Dream Team.
Oh my God! You're now part of my team. You're part of my team now.
Why is she out there?
Billy and Emily England. Mel B has given you the golden buzzer and taken you from Simon's Dream Team. They're going right to the finals, y'all.
Whose team is it?
Mel B. Emily, how does this make you feel?
I feel really excited. I feel amazing.
Honestly, when Simon called me, the 11-year-old Emily was a little bit upset. I really wanted to be part of Mel B's team.
Oh! It's all revealed!
Oh, that's show business.
Take that!
I actually feel like I've just been dumped.
Give it up one more time! Careful.
I'm so happy.
Why would you do that to
me? Because I can.
All that rubbing soul in the wound.
Oh, my God.
A man named John Hill has murdered 5 men. His last victim was found holding this book. Amanda, hold the bell in your hand. Ring the bell. Stop. Ring it again. Stop. I sense you have special powers.
I didn't do anything then.
Amanda, what was the name of his last male victim.
Tom?
Let us see if you are right. There is 800 pages in this book. Tell me any page number.
57.
Now, open book at 57. Tear out the page from the book. Amanda, bring me the paper.
I'm sorry, babe. May the Lord be with
you. It. What was the name again?
Tom.
Open the book on the missing page.
It says Tom.
Victim's name. Let's find Tom.
Oh no, let's not. Let's not find Tom.
These are all the John Hill's victims. Which one do you think is Tom? Look at the photo. Amanda,
yeah.
What you don't realize is that Tom has been with you
no.
longer than what you think. Simon, pick up the photo and look at it.
No. My God.
This is not the end. It's just the beginning.
never talk to me, do you? Well, let me do the talking for you. Your first name is Sacred, and your second name is Rihanna. Rihanna.
You know what I do remember about her?
What?
Her act was one of the most viral acts of all time. Oh, no.
Jesus.
Not toward me. Oh, my gosh.
Her hands are ice cold.
Pick one. Don't look.
Match the piece.
Match the piece. Is that with that?
Ooh.
Is that good?
Howie.
Ooh, ooh. I feel like I got stabbed in the back. How did?
Ashes.
He's gone for now. But he already knows your name, Howie.
Did you guys hear that? There's a voice saying Howie. Just me? I swear to you. Okay. All right. I'm good. Just
take the knives out.
Oh, no. It says I'm coming for you, Howie. Where'd she go? Oh, my gosh.
Where did she go?
Great.
What happened? I don't...
Is it over?
I'm coming for you, Howie. Okay.
Are we at the end of
thank
that?
You.
Is everyone as confused as I am?
I don't know what's going on.
Apparently somebody's coming for me, so I would like to get the judging out of the way and so that I can leave.
I don't know what to say. Has it finished?
No, I don't think it's finished.
I'm finished.
Has it finished?
I really, legitimately, I'm not kidding. I'm telling you that I'm terrified.
Terrified of what?
Read the notes!
I mean, Howie's terrified because someone is coming for
I
Howie,
I was poked
but
in the back.
We're
I was
good.
Stabbed in the back.
We're good.
He knows my name, and he's coming for me. Is that judging? Have we done what we're paid to do?
Yes, yes. Very good.
Let's move on with the show, then. Let's see another act, something that'll get rid of...
That gets rid of the juju vibe.
Yeah.
Hi, Simon.
How are you doing?
We are good. We are so excited.
Yes! So, tell everybody where you're from and what brings you to Britain's Got Talent today.
Okay. We are from Uganda, Kampala, Africa. So we are going to dance for you guys and for you judges.
Yes!
Oh, thank you!
And have you brought anyone with you?
Mr. Kavma Dauda.
Is he there?
Yes.
Can you say hi? Can we say hi?
Yeah, go on, please do.
Hi. Oh, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Tell us a little bit about this group.
I have 30 kids that I'm taking care of. Some are orphans. We are using music, dance and drama to make lives better.
Amazing. Oh my God, it's amazing.
Bless you, darling. That's incredible. And the stage is yours.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, look, look, oh!
We are the Ghetto Kids from the Pearl of Africa, Uganda.
Yeah! Oh!
Thank you.
stars illuminating. It's a place for a you and I. A little space for a you and I.
Before.
Look at them!
Oh! Oh yeah! Come on! Yeah! Show it to me! Yeah! Oh! Oh!
Oh. Yeah, amazing. 100% deserved.
That's never actually happened. Normally, the golden buzzer is pressed afterwards.
Oh, I got it wrong!
Yeah, someone didn't explain the rules of Britain's Got Talent to him.
He gave you the golden buzzer, and you performed with the confetti. It was magical. And by the way, who's this little one?
My name is Josephine.
Hello, Josephine. How old are you, Josephine?
5 years. Oh,
I just want to say, you're absolute superstars, every single one of you. What you're doing is absolutely incredible, and we are honoured that you have come to Britain's Got Talent. You've lit up the stage, and yes, the energy in the room and joy is incredible. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Your talent is unbelievable.
And it felt to me like you'd really raised the bar on Britain's Got Talent. So well done.
I wasn't literally exploding, I'm telling you. You should be proud of yourself. I can't wait to see you back. That's all I can say.
I think it's incredible that you're so young, you've flown all the way, and no fear, this is an audition we're going to remember. And it was brilliant. That's what this show is all about. Yeah. And that's what the Golden Buzzer is for.
Tonight, I'm a huge fan, and I've been following you guys for a long time on social media.
Thank you.
You always put a smile on my face and everybody's face, and I think at this time in our lives, nothing is more important than putting a smile on anybody's face.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Heidi?
I think all of you are absolutely adorable. I love the comedy within the dancing. I love when you break it all down and it's like slow motion, everything. It was beautiful. Thank you for that.
I'm just going to say what I think everybody in the audience is thinking, which is, you are just brilliant. Seriously brilliant. So talented. You work hard for this. Winning is important to you. Thank you for coming all this way. It means a lot.
I love you guys. Feed Mel B. Yes!
On this table over here, I've written over 100 words that describe emotions that people can feel when they watch magic. Amanda, can you please join me up on stage? Yes. On your way up, can you please pick up a piece of paper and look at it? Don't let anyone else see and don't tell me.
Okay.
Can you please sit here? Start to mix this, we'll explain what's about to happen. With the help of my friends from the Magic Circle Young Magicians Club.
The Young Magicians Club.
We're going to do some magic that should hopefully blow your mind. Behind us is a framework containing 16 holes that fit a Rubik's Cube exactly. Each of my friends is holding a Rubik's Cube. Which, like you, they're randomly mixing. At any point, Amanda, I'd like you to stop it from your Rubik's Cube. When you do, in a loud voice, please say stop and hold your cube high in the air.
Stop.
Now, Amanda, there are 200 quintillion ways that a Rubik's Cube can be mixed. All the cubes are mixed in a different way that nobody could possibly know. Everyone in the audience, if you've got a phone, can you please switch the torch on and hold it high in the air?
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.
Remaining. Do you want to mix your cubes some more or leave it as it is?
I'm going
to
leave it as it is.
Now, before this all began, when you'd first sat down with me, I asked you to pick a word. What was that word?
It was love.
I would like you to help me create a brand new magic word.
A magic word?
But first, I have gifts. You see, I love drawing and colouring in, and I've drawn you each a picture to look at later. This one's for you, Howie.
All right.
This one's for you, Heidi.
Thank you.
This one's for you, Sophia. And this one's for you, Simon.
Now, don't peek inside the envelopes. Don't let anyone else touch them. We'll get back to them later. What you're about to see is amazing, but I can't do it on my own. I need help. Luckily, I have lots of friends that love magic just like me.
Oh, hello there. Hi, friends.
We got a lot of friends.
Wow. I'll let each of you to pick one of my friends, pick one of the numbers, and I'll place it in this holder. You get to choose which position it goes in. There are multiple combinations, and the choices are all yours. We'll start with you, Harry. Please name one of my friends.
Me? Mark.
And would you like the number 7 or 23?
I'll take 7, it's lucky.
And where would you like it to go? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
First, because I'm first.
Okay, so number 1. Heidi, it's your turn.
I choose
Would you like 11 or 26?
11.
And where would you like that to go? 2, 3, or 4?
4.
Thank you, Heidi. Sophie, it's your turn. Which of my friends would you like?
Skylar.
And would you like 24 or 10?
10.
And where would you like it to go? 2 or 3?
2.
Thanks, Sophia. And Simon, which of my friends would you like?
Jordan.
Jordan. And would you like 1 or 15? 1. And we'll try something a little bit different with you. Would you like to put it in last position or swap it out for another one? Okay.
My position. He's taking my position.
Okay. Thanks, Simon. Now, let's look at the drawings you didn't use. As you can see, they're all different. We've got things like Lego, dragons, we've got burgers. So they're all different, yeah?
Yes.
Let's look at the drawings you did choose. You chose a snake, a slice of lime, a house, and some mountains. Each of you had a free choice of which drawing you wanted, and more importantly, where to put it. The snake looks like an S, the lime looks like a C, the house looks like an A, and the mountains look like an M. That spells the word scam, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I said earlier we're going to create a brand new magic word. That can be our magic word. Everyone shout scam as loud as they can on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3.
Scam!
But what if I told you that we knew what the magic word would be before you even picked it? At the beginning of my act, I gave you each a drawing to hold on to. I'd like to take the drawing out of the envelope and show it to everyone. As you can see, they match. Now, as well as having something on the front of their T-shirt, my friends also had something on the back. Look. Word equals scam. Now, look.
Okay, so I'm at AGT. I'm gonna go in, do what I need to do, get out as fast as I can.
Okay, let's go.
I can't believe I'm actually inside the AGT theatre. Wait, there's a desk. Better be quick. Can't get caught.
What is he doing?
Something there. Oh, God, someone's going to hate this. What's that? Oh, God, I've got to run. Come on.
Now, you're probably wondering what I did at the desk, Simon. Well, hopefully you're not too mad. Watch this.
It says scam everywhere.
Look, scam, 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 scam. Sorry, Simon.
Whoa. What's your name, please?
My name is Musa Wakwamota. I'm originally from South Africa, but I've recently moved to London.
Oh, you did? Fantastic. Tell me about you, please.
I got diagnosed with cancer when I was young. That's led to the amputation. And I was a football player before I got amputated. And then after my amputation, I fell in love with music. My friends, they were dancing at that time. I asked them to teach me how to dance. So they threw like boxes on the floor, and then they were like, okay, this is how you do it. Your left crotch, use it as a left leg. And then that's how it started. And then I'm in London, I'm in UK, I'm in my favorite country, England. This is the perfect time for me to actually reach out to more people and inspire a lot of people out there. And yeah, that's...
Yeah. That's incredible. So, how long have you spent preparing for this audition?
Since, I think, forever. I've been imagining myself on stage, and now it's happening, I'm like, yeah, that's...
Yeah, I get it. I get it. Okay, well, look, no more questions.
Okay.
Good luck.
Thank you. I hope you enjoy.
Can you imagine what he's been through?
No. No.
Standing still, nothing else matters now. You're not here, so where are you? I've been calling you, I'm missing you.
Beautiful.
musicians that I think I've ever seen on this show. So much admiration for you, everything you've been through. You're clearly somebody, no matter what they put their mind to, you will achieve it. So well done.
That was exceptional. We all agree with that. Listen to me. We use them all. We use them all. Please, please. If they do it again, they kill me. But no, they're going to kill me.
The word impossible into you. I am possible. I thank you so much.
You're an absolute hero.
In the oceans of me, I
Yes! Incredible.
Musa, let me just tell you what's happening right now. There's about 1,500 people on their feet,
yes!
Some people in tears. Everyone's cheering. Even though it was remote, it was close. Honestly, I have so much respect for you as a person, as an artist. You are exceptional.
Thank you.
To think that somebody who loses a leg and loses the opportunity to play football would make their next choice dancing is so unbelievable, and you have reached such heights, and there are people with twice as many legs as you that don't come close to what I just witnessed right here.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Can I just say, I went to dance college. I trained as a dancer, and I didn't have half as much control or technique that you have. Hopefully, you've opened up the door, so more of this. We see more of this. We need to see more of this. Yeah. And you do it so elegantly. And you're really cute. You're gorgeous. Flawless and gorgeous. Yes?
I'm so proud of you. Congrats.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, Abshay.
He's great.
He's amazing.
He is.
Even remotely, it was amazing what came through the screen from so far.
This is my song. In the shower. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. Good to see you. All right, man, let's get this out the way. Obviously, I'm from Brixton. No, I'm joking. I'm from America, y'all. What's up? Yeah, apparently Englanders think we're dumb. And you're right, we're dumb. But we got dentists, okay? You can't have everything, all right? I'm feeling good, man. I'm feeling good from this jet lag. I drank some coffee. I normally don't drink coffee. So when I did, I was surprised. And I felt so energetic. I was like, man, I feel so energetic. I feel so energized and alert. Why don't I drink more coffee? And then my booty was like, this is why, and snuck up on me. I was not ready. You ever accidentally start the saucer to the bathroom? You're like, where did I learn this? It was bad. You ever go to the bathroom thinking you only gotta pee, and then when you get there, your body's like, nah, son, we got work to do. I destroyed that bathroom. I couldn't breathe for 11 seconds. I lost brain cells. I was like, why is my arm in the toilet? It was so big, but I'm good. Some of y'all had that experience, all right. So, man, I was on a show called America's Got Talent. That's why I know you, Simon. Yeah, I was on America's Got Talent. And who's seen that? Who's seen America's Got Talent? Who's seen me on America's? Have you seen me? Have you seen me? Okay. Who voted for me, though? Of course you didn't, London. I lost to a 12-year-old ventriloquist. She didn't open her mouth the whole time. You never know what it feels like losing $1 million to somebody that still has chores. You'll never know. People ask me all the time, they're like, you still talk to Darcy? I'm like, she's 14, bruh. No, I'm a grown man. What am I gonna do? Hey, Darcy, how was school? Like, no, man. Plus, she beat me, so I hate her. Why would I talk to someone I hate? Don't hate Darcy, she's an angel. So is the devil, okay? Now, I'm not, she's not the devil. I love her and her family. They're great. I don't feel like I lost on this show for a couple reasons. First reason I don't feel like I lost on the show is because I was homeless 3.5 years ago. I'm far from that now, all right? I'll never be homeless again in my life. Thank you. That's right. That's right. I got money now. I got way more friends and family members than I remember. On the show, I don't know if y'all know who Tyra Banks is, but she's pretty much, yeah, y'all know who Tyra Banks is. If you don't know, welcome to Earth. And she's pretty much the American version of Ant and Dec. You know, they're both like hosts on major shows and they're both supermodels. So they're the same people. And on the show, she licked my face, okay? I could die tonight. You don't understand. She licked my face, y'all. I licked her hand first, though. I licked her hand first. All right, what happened was she was interviewing me, and I was like, I can't believe I'm talking to you, Tyra Banks. And she was like, yeah, it's me. And she put her hand out. And she was like, you can pinch my hand and see if I'm real. Matter of fact, you can kiss it. And I was like, kiss it? Because I don't know when I'm going to get this opportunity again. So I licked her. She started laughing. I was like, thank you, Jesus. I'm not going to jail. I went on stage, right? She was interviewing me, right? She was like, you ready to do this? I was like, I'm ready. She was like, go get him, Tiger. I laughed. I was like, funny you call me a tiger, because I'm feeling great, like the cereal, because in America, don't worry about it. Anyway, so I went on stage, and you know how the judges on these shows, they always ask you all these random questions, like, hey, preacher, what's your favorite color? You got a favorite color? Huh? You got a girlfriend? What's your girlfriend? And at the time, I had a girlfriend. So I was like, yeah, I got a girl. She dope. I do my performance. I get off stage. Tyra Banks is waiting for me. Everybody happy but Tyra, all right? I walk off, and she's mad. She was like, why would you let me lick your face on national television, preacher? You got a girlfriend. And I replied, I'll let you lick my face, Tyra, because you're Tyra Banks, okay? Why would I not let Tyra Banks lick my face? If my girl had a chance for Aunt and Dec to lick her face and she turned it down, I'm dumping her because I don't want to date anybody that stupid. Are you serious? If I had a chance for Aunt and Dec to lick my face, I am dressing up like an ice cream cone. You don't understand. They about to get all this. My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I love you. Thank you. Thank you. I love you. Hey, you right there.
Oh, let's get this out the way. Come here. Come here.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Okay, here.
Funny.
I love you. What's I love up? This guy. How you doing?
Preacher Lawson.
Hey, what's up, Howard Mendel?
Are you happy that he picked you?
I am so. I feel like it's a golden opportunity. Well, it could have been a golden opportunity.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I can't believe.
Actually,
I'm a comedian, Howie.
Yes.
Howie, you did know the preacher was coming on tonight, right? But you gave your golden buzzer to another act.
In the moment, I got caught up in emotion.
To be fair, they look like me with my shirt off, so that's... Every time I've been on America's Got Talent, I've been losing, and this time I'm here to take over, okay?
That's what I want.
Showed him the laugh.
All right. What's up, y'all? Good to be back on America's Got Talent. This is great, man. Changed my life. Got the tour everywhere. Got the tour. I was in England. In England! Sorry, that was weird. I'm sorry. England! I like doing that. I know. I know it's bad. I like doing it, though. England! But it's bad. But, like, you know who else does really bad impressions? English people when they do American accents. It's bad, too. They always do the same accent. I'm from America! Every time. They do that one, or they do, like, I'm American, right? Or the third one is, yo, 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 my man. I'm like, I wonder what race he is. You know, they just assume all black people in America sound like DMX for some reason. America in the building, where my dogs? I gotta pee, all right? I don't know how to transition. I'm just letting you know I gotta pee. You ever have to pee like real bad, like, you know, real bad? You had a public restroom, right? Right? And instead of it saying like men or women, they try to be creative. It's like a boat and a fish. You're like, which one? Everyone's walking to the wrong restroom. Every woman in here has walked in and been like, when they put urine on inside the restroom? And every dude has walked in like, is that a couch? They got a couch? Is that a vending machine? What kind of candy is that? That's some weird candy. They got lotion? Why they got lotion inside the restroom? Can't have a lotion in the men's restroom.
Oh! Oh!
Yeah. You know, because we're not going to use it. It's a waste of lotion. What are y'all laughing at? What were y'all laughing at? It's funny because women are cleaner than men until it comes to your restroom. I went into a woman's restroom, I seen pee on the toilet. Like, I expect that in a men's restroom. Fellas, how many times you walked in the restroom and you seen pee on the ground immediately? Right? Who's that guy walking in? Oh, man, I was so close. There's always some old dude peeing 3 feet from the toilet. It's like, come on, man. We all know you don't got that much horsepower. But women are funny. Women are the only people that go to the restroom in groups. You rarely see dudes. I got to pee, Brandon. Let's roll, brother. Should say something. Let's get out of here, man. Where's Tyler at? Tyler here? Yeah. All three of us, we can go together, you know? Hopefully they got a couch. You know, we can take selfies. That'd be awesome. That'd be nice. Is that lotion? My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. Y'all are awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.
You got jokes. You got charisma. I don't have a golden buzzer anymore.
You don't!
But I got a feeling you're not gonna need it. I got a feeling that you're gonna be one of the six that go through today.
Thank you.
I feel like this was the funniest set ever. Not even just from you, from anyone ever.
Oh, wow.
Doing a set.
Oh, you better stop, girl. You what?
The only way you can judge this is, did we laugh more? And the answer is yes.
Yes!
That is what I would call a winning performance.
Oh!
And I really like you.
Yes, we love you.
How is my hype man? I appreciate that.
I love you, buddy.
I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant. That was so good. You're so good.
I'm simply taking a red handkerchief I'm pushing it into my fist. I'm then gonna snap my fingers and show, look, it's turned into an egg, and the handkerchief is back in my pocket.
Your brother's magic!
Hello!
Hello, what's your name?
My name's Jasper Cherry. I just turned 14 years old on Tuesday.
Oh, look at him, he's so cute.
Happy birthday.
I think you're a magician.
Yes, I am.
Nice.
Jasper, who have you brought with you?
I've got my mum and my sister Izzy.
Jasper, what would it mean to you to win Britain's Got Talent?
Oh, it'd be amazing. I'd love to perform for the royal family, and, well, the money would be great as well.
Jasper, we are all rooting for you. Take a deep breath and show us what you can do.
Thank you. Thanks. Simon, I'm sure by now, well, you must be absolutely sick to death of card tricks. Like, you won't want to see one at all for the rest of your life.
How did you know that?
I've got friends. Instead, I'm simply taking a red handkerchief and pushing it into my fist. I'm then gonna snap my fingers and show, look, it's turned into an egg, and the handkerchief is back in my pocket.
Your brother's magic!
Now, today, I actually thought it'd be fun to teach you this trick. Everything isn't quite as it seems, because look, there's a hole in the back of the egg, and that's where I've hidden another handkerchief. It's that simple. David, are you with me still?
Yes.
Yes, good. Right, okay. So here's the setup. Take out your red handkerchief and you simply say you're gonna push it into your fist. But what the audience don't know is that it's actually going into the hole. Right? So then you snap your fingers and you show, look, it's an egg, and the handkerchief is back in your pocket. The one thing that you have to remember to do is not show this side of the egg. It'll completely ruin the trick, and the magician, well, it'd look like a bit of a fool, really. Unless, of course, you're a real magician.
Oh.
And you can simply remove the hole.
a relay!
I'm just Cherry. Thank you. Goodbye.
Jasper, that was fantastic. So original. We've never seen it presented like that. And none of this fazed you, which is incredible. You are a little star.
What did you think, Lee?
I think you really stand out because you presented it in a completely unique way. You do have magic powers. Well done, Jasper.
I just felt completely relaxed. You were charming, you were witty, you were cool. I mean, you ticked every single box and you're only 14. It was an amazing audition.
Thanks.
Really
thanks.
Good.
14 still.
I think what was really cool, how old are you?
14! He said he was 14, she said he was 14, he's 14! He turned 14 on Tuesday. He's still 14.
So just to be clear, you're 14.
Yes.
Okay, so that makes it even better. You, young man, have got a huge future ahead of you, I think.
Thank you.
I do.
Hey, let's vote, Simon.
Yeah, I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me, Jasper.
It's a yes from me.
Four yeses, Jasper, well done.
Hello. Hello. I know who you are, but introduce yourself to everybody here.
I'm Jasper Cherry. I'm 16 years old, and I'm from Lancashire in England. Yeah. Ah.
Jasper, how many years ago was it you were on BGT?
2 years ago.
2 years ago?
Yeah.
Okay, and you got how far?
I made it all the way to the finals. Now, tonight, I'm going to try and prove to you all that time travel really does exist, which I know is a crazy thing. And Heidi, please can you come and join me up on stage and make sure you've got your cell phone with you too. Round of applause for Heidi. Come on guys, keep it going. Heidi, you can take a seat, thank you so much.
Yeah.
I've got a deck of cards here.
Okay.
And I need a favor from you. I want you to tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Right there?
Yep.
Okay. I want you to take that card,
yep.
Show it round, and it doesn't matter if I see this card as well, because this is not a card trick. The five of spades. Make sure it's face up, place it somewhere around the middle. There we go, okay. Now, everyone, I want you to remember this moment right here, where all the cards were face down, apart from one, and that is your card, the five of spades.
Yes.
Now we'll do this again. I'm gonna take about half the cards face up and half the cards face down. And I'm gonna mix them together. There's a technical term for this, Heidi. It's called a mess.
A mess.
Now, Heidi, I want you to take the five of spades
yeah.
and turn it face down
mm-hmm.
and then place it once again somewhere around the middle. Okay. Now, you've got your phone there and I'm gonna take a picture of you. Is that okay?
Sure.
Perfect. I also want you to hold onto these cards. Okay, maybe use both hands. Make sure you don't drop them.
Nope.
Okay. And I want you to give me your best model face. So here we go. Perfect. I'll take the cards from you. All right. Audience, are you ready to prove that time travel really does exist? Okay, here we go then. And we're gonna use my phone for this. So here we go. I want you to watch closely as you will see the time start ticking back. One, two, three, four, five. Heidi, we've just gone back in time. 5 minutes. I want you to look at your phone and show me the time on your phone as well.
Yeah,
look,
6:45.
We've both gone back in time. 5 minutes. But that's not it. Audience, I want you to take your phones out right now. You have all just gone back in time. 5 minutes. If we really have gone back in time,
yeah.
then this deck of cards that was a mess should now have returned to the point that I asked you all to remember when they were all face down apart from the five of spades.
Yes, there it is.
There it is. Now, Heidi,
yes.
a few minutes ago we took a picture on your phone.
Yes.
So because we went back in time 5 minutes and the deck of cards has changed, that picture has also changed. So I want you to go to that picture.
Mm-hmm.
You can see that Heidi, you were in fact holding a deck of cards that is all facing one way.
Yes.
Apart from your card, the sign of spades. But Heidi, if I really could time travel, then why not go back more than 5 minutes? Why not go back before I even left my home in England? Then I'd know what your card was, the five of spades.
Yes.
And I did. And if you don't believe me, watch this. I'm leaving home right now to come to you guys in America. I am super excited to come and see you. It's currently 5 a.m. I'm just looking for a gate now. So, there it is. I'm on the plane now and I'm about to take my seat. I'm finally here at the airport in LA. I'm gonna go over to the hotel and I'll see you very soon.
You went back.
Heidi, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amazing.
Wow.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
Hi, and who are you?
We're just us.
Yeah.
No, I said, who are you?
Oh, I'm Julia.
I'm Annie.
I'm Alice.
I'm Poppy.
I'm Becky.
Now tell me the name of the group.
Just Us!
Tell me a little bit about you guys, how you met.
Well, we've met at dancing because we've been dancing together since we were about 5.
Yeah.
But this group came together because I've got scoliosis, so...
Sorry, darling, what is that?
Scoliosis is like a curvature of the spine.
Right.
My one's quite rare because it's more common to, like, have an accident and get it, but I was born with it. So I have to have surgery soon. And after surgery, I won't be able to dance, so this is like my last chance because I've always wanted to do
it. Are you serious?
Yeah.
You've got an amazing attitude, I've got to tell you.
Thank you.
You really have. Good luck.
Thank you so much.
Oh, bless her.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls.
from the whole crowd, judges, us.
David?
Well, it was absolutely stunning performance. Obviously, when you told us that story, we were all hoping and praying it would be fantastic, but it so far exceeded all our expectations. It's a beautiful story about friendship and a stunning performance.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely. And your friendship and strength together is just fantastic. It's lovely to watch. And it was an amazing dance routine.
Alicia.
I have so much admiration for you girls right now. I can't tell you. And just seeing how you've all come together with this beautiful friendship that you've got, and when you're passionate about something, I could not imagine not being able to ever do that again. I really couldn't. And you know, and that's what we all live for the things that we love to do. It really touched me, so much so that I'm gonna do.
I think you're the kind of person who's got determination regardless of what happens.
He's not going to stop me.
See you in the finals.
Ladies, these are the Mersey girls. Tell us a little bit about you.
We've all been dancing together since we were literally tiny. It's what we all wanted to do as a career. That didn't end up happening for me. I was diagnosed with a condition called scoliosis, which is a curvature of the spine. And I was told that my dance career would end after I get surgery to fix that. So we were like, let's go out with a bang before my surgery. And we applied for Britain's Got Talent. That's when we ended up getting on the show and I met Simon. And that's when he completely changed my life. So there was a surgery here in America that meant I would be able to dance after, but it was over in America. I'm from the UK. So Simon said he's going to help me get that surgery. So he flew me out.
Wow.
Wow, buddy. This is not your child that you took care of, a human being.
He is nice sometimes. He's really
nice. I'm really impressed.
Yeah.
When I want to give up, will you be by my side? If I fall, will I fall alone? Or will you be there to catch me?
Picture a place where it all doesn't hurt, where everything's safe and it doesn't get worse. Oh my, we see through bloodshot eyes. Are we running out of time? Are we hiding from the light? Are we just too scared to fight for what we want tonight? Close your eyes and leave all behind. Go with love on our side. It's a trust fall, baby.
Our side, it's a trust fall.
Howie.
You know, I thought what I watched is very good, and it is a beautiful story, and I'm really moved. But this stage is kind of hosting the best of the best, and I don't know if it's great.
I do have 2 metal rods in my spine.
Yeah.
I try my best.
Okay, yes. Well, you're fantastic, and I'm very proud of you, young lady.
Thank you.
I feel like you dance, all of you, you dance like a well-oiled machine. But I do have to also be honest, you know, I find it a little bit snoozy. I do. You know, because we do have dance acts on the stage that are really like flying through the air and they
but
do
just
wilder.
You don't care about them. You don't know them. And, you know, in other dance groups, they just get replaced. These girls all stuck together and we're like, no, you
are
coming back in.
Simon? What do you think?
I like acts who want to win, who put the hours in and get better. And that's what you did tonight.
And Mel's right. A lot of other people would have just said goodbye and carried on without you. But they didn't. They stuck by you. And stories are important.
Yes.
I think you're going to inspire a lot of people, and I think the audience will vote you through to the next round because you deserve it.
Thank you so much.
Well done, Jersey Girl.
Come here, guys. How does that feel?
Amazing.
Yeah?
Very mysterious.
I know.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Oh,
my God, it's a sword.
I don't know what he's going to do, but it involves a sword, so you shouldn't try this at home. Okay?
I'm actually having a hot flush already.
No, don't do that.
No, get off.
No.
Why is he looking at you?
No, not me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I think you
I've never seen anything like this before.
My heart's pounding.
Oh my goodness.
I got up shame.
Oh God.
Hold on, where's he hooking then?
God, I can't.
What do you think, Howie?
It's amazing, it's crazy, it's dangerous, it's wrong. You should change your name to Shishka Bob.
Heidi. Are you okay? Sophia.
I have mixed feelings. This is very disturbing and fun at the same time. It's like I like you and I don't like you at the same time.
I love that because we've seen this kind of act before, but the stuff I've seen before like this is tame in comparison, in my opinion. If anything, the act was too short. Okay, we're gonna vote. Howie, yes or no?
It's a yes for me. It's like crazy.
Heidi.
I want to say no, but I have to say yes.
Yeah.
I don't want to see you again, and I can't wait. Yes.
You've got four yeses. We'll see you again.
Oh, he's jolly.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Uexa Kazuhisa.
And why are you here on Britain's Got Talent?
ここにビッグチャンスがあると思ったからです。
Because there's a big chance you give me.
What? What? Oh, we're going to give you a big chance. We are.
はい。
Have you seen the show before?
Of course.
And so is this your day job, what you're going to do for us today?
International variety performance.
You're an international variety performer, okay.
And what is your day job?
He's an international variety performer. Unless his job has changed in the last few seconds, I say it's still international variety performer. The stage is yours.
Jumping.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, are you aware that the winner of this show gets to perform in front of the royal family?
Of course.
It was highly erotic.
Thank you. You would understand me, I thought.
We're always looking for something different on the show. And we've never seen an act quite like you before. So, arigato gozaimasu.
Arigato gozaimasu.
Yes.
Let me kick this off with a note.
A yes from me.
Oh, it's a yes from me.
Hang on a second. Let's give this a drum roll.
I wonder what I'm going to say. It's a yes from me.
For me. Welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi. I'm good.
Good.
Well, okay.
The first thing I want to say is...
Okay.
Wes is very nervous.
Oh, very nervous, yeah. I'm very nervous.
Well, look, I don't want to give anything away, so good luck.
He's sweating.
Simon, well, he's nervous. Sweating.
But why is he nervous?
Because he wants to win.
He's balancing
means a lot.
On a sword.
Well, you'll see. It's very dangerous, this act.
10 seconds.
Let's see what your mentoring has done.
Shh, shh, shh.
Okay, here we go.
Come on, Wes. Come on, Wes.
Girl, look at that body.
You kidding?
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out when I walk in the spot. This is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
We think the guys at the store to dangerous looks.
Oh, wow.
Girl, look at that body. Oh! Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Now the big finale.
I'm sexy and I know it.
These are your ideas.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Yeah! That's how you do it, Wes!
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself.
He is disgusted, bro. Yeah.
I feel alive.
I actually got quite emotional. Listen, I think Mel is just being over-competitive, didn't need to buzz you, so why didn't you like that?
I did need to buzz because I've just wasted, what, 4 minutes of my life that I'm never going to get back.
Really?
I didn't... Yes, really.
Really? Eh?
Really, really. So you would pay to go and watch it, you know what?
People love him.
Yeah!
Thank you.
At the end of the day, you know, we just had two guys balancing on swords.
And you don't think that was dangerous at the end?
That none of it was dangerous. Stopping me.
Really?
Really, yeah.
Okay.
All right, which is because you didn't get him on your team. Howie.
Simon obviously worked with you on the nipple tug.
Trust me, when you see this back on TV, it's going to look a lot better.
Yeah, and, but, I, and but you this know is the voting audience.
Yeah, and,
well,
true.
Yes, but these ones are going to love this show.
I don't know about that. We have audience right here, and they're not sure about it.
These don't like
they
it.
They did.
No, they did not.
Well, these ones loved it.
No, they just they shook their
can
heads.
Can I just say something?
There's nothing that you can say to make people vote.
He has spent 2 years preparing for this performance. He's flown a long, long time to be here. He's emotional. He wants to win. And yes, it might not be your cup of tea, but we look for things that are different. You're unique. You're funny. And I really like you.
I love you, USA, America. Yeah. This is true. This is true. America, I love you.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Arigato.
That was better than the two guys with the sword and the girl with the ring.
Different level.
How do you think he got here today?
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Keiji Iwasaki.
Where are you from?
I'm from Japan.
Oh, I love Japan.
Ah, thank you so much.
Watashi wa arigatou.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, this is...
That's all I know.
Lisa-san.
How old are you?
Yeah, I'm 49 years old.
And what you're doing for us today, is that your day job?
No, it's my bicycle and... No. Sorry. Pardon. I'm a little bit nervous, so excuse
no
me.
No worries, my darling. So why Britain's Got Talent?
It's because a big stage, the biggest stage in the world, then it's like one of my dreams to come here.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes, it's amazing.
Wow, it's a pleasure to have you.
Yeah.
And what would you do with the money if you were to win?
I want to across the Atlantic Ocean by rowing a boat. So
yes.
Then I want to buy the boat.
Oh, fabulous.
You didn't expect that answer, did you?
No one's ever said that.
I love that. Yeah.
Okay, well,
yeah.
Whenever you're ready.
Yes.
Go for it.
Okay, now I start.
Yeah. Oh my God, I love him.
I'm laughing already.
Simon, hello. How are you? Because 100 times I saw you in YouTube. Hey, Simon, do you know this one?
Chopstick.
Yes, chopstick. One, two, three. Sorry. One more time. Sorry. Just this.
What did you just do?
It's not the magic. I'm joking. Now I start. Let's start the magic.
He's good. He's funny.
Well, then maybe ask the Deke and the aunt.
Yes.
Deck and Ant, bro.
That's got a ring
to it. It's
Ant and Deck. Ant and Deck,
that's right.
Please check this card is normal. And please shuffle it.
Of course.
Yes, very well.
Deck, shuffle the deck.
Deck
shuffled
yes,
by
perfect.
Deck and Ant.
Yes. Please take one card as you like.
Me?
Yeah, no.
Next to the Ant.
No. Okay, please show everybody. I don't see it. I don't want to see it. Okay, please show the audience.
No.
What?
No, I'm doing this bit.
Okay, may I put it here? And I just scroll. Now I show the Japanese way to shuffling. Okay.
Wata. Here, your card is wata.
There. The queen, this or this?
No.
This one?
No.
This. No. What? Just here. Is your card?
Yes.
Wow. How do you put the card in and then on it?
No, I put... Just move. Hop. Whoa. Did you see it? It's boring. No.
That's so good.
Stop. Oh, stop. There's the island. Now, let's hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Amazing.
I didn't know Japan was creating wizards. What's going on over here?
£20. And do you want it?
No. I put here
20 pounds. Hup. Hiya. See, it's like a going to energy of this nature. Hiya. Now, what? Excuse me, energy finished. But no problem. Genki dama. Hiya. My last trick is for ladies.
For ladies?
Yes. Alicia, do you come over here?
I come over here.
Well...
You didn't do an awful lot there, did you?
He didn't ask us to, did he?
Alicia! Okay, arigato. Please check this is what? What is this?
It's a ring.
It's a ring, yes. Give me a finger like this. I put the ring here. Okay. Just hold on, don't move, because it's a very difficult magic. This ring, your finger. Hat, one, two, three. No. Passing. Whoa! I said, wait, wait, hold on. Hop. What?
You are very, very charming, and your magic was absolutely excellent. Yes. I mean, faultless.
Thank you so much. It's too much.
You're the funniest person we've seen and the most magical person we've seen, all combined in one, and I love you.
Yes, thank you so much.
You are an absolute natural.
People are going to like you so much.
Thank you so
My son
much.
Is going to love you. I mean, love you. You are one of the best we've seen so far.
Isn't that lovely?
Yes, thank you so much.
The audience love you. I love you too. You're a superstar, so I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Yes, thank you so much.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Hello!
Hello! Simon! Do you remember me?
Of course I remember you.
Wow.
Forget you and I have met. Tell us who you are. What's the dream?
Okay, my name is Keiji Wasaki, and I have been traveling with bicycle. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here.
Okay, so why are you here?
No, because it's a big, big opportunity to show my magic all over the world.
All right, good luck, Keiji.
Yeah, thank you. Arigato gozaimasu.
Arigato.
Yep.
He's already making me laugh.
He's very funny.
Here we go. Hello, Simon.
Hi, Ketchy.
Hello, Howie.
Hello.
Okay, yep, I have two handkerchiefs here. Okay, please.
Okay.
Could you make a knot? Is it possible?
It is possible.
Yeah, yes, please make a knot.
What you're doing.
Okay. Yes. Very tight, please.
Okay.
Very tight, please.
Okay. Right. Dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun. Okay.
Okay.
Then, okay, one more time, please.
Another
make
knot.
Make sure tight, okay. Yes.
And you dance, too.
Yeah. Very tight, please.
I know.
Very tight, huh?
I'm doing it tight.
Simon, do you want to check it? Please
yeah.
Check it.
We do.
Yes, pull past tight, the shirt is tight. And it's very tight.
That's a knot.
Okay, that's a knot. Now, usually it's how long does it take to untie?
2 minutes, 3 minutes.
No, maybe 3 days. But give me a hand like this.
What?
Open like this.
It is.
Just put it. Hold here. Hold,
okay.
Hold. Yes.
Hold it.
But don't move. It's very dangerous. Okay?
Okay.
Don't move.
Okay.
What the? Open your hand.
What happened?
Open your hand. Here you go.
Oh!
Next magic is this one.
Whoa.
I need a LED light from here.
What?
Oh, Howie, sorry, here. No, Heidi, in here. Sorry, excuse me. No, Simon, open your mouth. Ah, Nini. I get off. Ah, oh. No, Howie, no, in the ear.
It's in my ear.
A little bit like this. Okay, now. Now, oh, again.
Okay.
Yeah,
no, oh.
Hi, could you come join me to the stage?
Yes.
Thank you.
We are tall.
Yes.
Sorry. Yes, my last trick is this. This is what? Blind hood. So can you see anything?
Well, now I can. You want me to put it on?
Yes. No. No, I can't see it.
No, okay. I can't see through it.
Okay.
Okay.
Now I put this like this.
Oh, you want it.
Yes. Now okay. I make like this. Then give me a finger like this. Is it okay? Can I touch this?
You can touch it.
Yes.
I'm not like Howie.
Okay. Sorry. Then I have a ring. Okay. Can I put one this here? Okay. Please don't move. It's a very difficult magic trick.
I won't move.
Okay.
Okay.
Give me a ring. Okay. Please don't move. It's incredibly difficult. This ring from here. Without watching. One, two, three. Oh! Is it flying? I can see it.
It's spinning.
Okay, now it's just like this, okay? Uncle also like this. Okay, now it's a passing.
Wow, that is weird.
Heidi, don't move.
I'm not moving.
Huh? It's a direct water.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Amazing. How far did you go at BGT?
Semi-final, but the judge's choice was not me.
Right, they didn't
choose. I remember.
Oh, I'm
Simon
sorry.
Simon was there.
Is the idea that you want to redeem yourself?
Yes, of course.
Because I think the super fans are going to love you. I love
you.
Yeah, I loved you already when it came onto the stage. You're super excited, which is getting me excited too, because you're like high speed and you're moving things around. Then I was right there with this ring, was amazing.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
Well, yeah, I mean, look, I've always liked you because a lot of magicians do take themselves very seriously on this show. And they are quite boring with their little car tricks and stuff like that. You, however, have a personality. People are going to like you. Let's see what happens.
What's your name?
My name is Killian O'Connor.
Nice to meet you, Killian. How old are you and where are you from?
I'm 13 years old and I come from County Meath, Ireland.
Amazing.
Hello. When I grow up, I want to be a magician. What do I like about magic? It's just trying to make people smile. Yay. If I can make them believe in magic and then perform at the Royal Variety Show, I would legitimately cry. Honestly, before I had the magic, my social skills were very bad. I would just be in the corner. I didn't want to be within 50 feet of anyone. Lots of people.
Just go in and enjoy the moment.
Okay. My legs would be shaking, my arms would be trembling.
Good luck when you're ready.
Simon. Think of a playing card.
Got it.
What is it?
You don't mess around, do you? Seven of diamonds.
Wrong. Sometimes everything is not quite as it seems. Watch. The black hole. A journey that begins where everything ends. I'd like to bring you on my journey. I've learned that having autism is not a disability, it's an ability. When I was younger, I was unable to interact with people. I felt a bit empty, incomplete. I felt invisible.
That was good, wasn't it?
After discovering magic, my life changed. It was like a light switch coming on inside my head. I found a way to interact with people through my magic.
No way, the milk's not in there. It is, you know.
Magic is my universe, and my life is now whole.
It is great, isn't it?
It's brilliant.
Really good.
I have a notepad here, and written on each page are some of my favorite sweets. Have a look and see.
Yeah.
Please, say stop.
Stop.
Could you please call out the treat you've stopped on?
Jelly beans.
Jelly beans. Earlier, I left a special gift for you. Could you please remove the lid and reveal the gift inside?
Sure.
Oh, no.
Oh my God.
How did you do that?
Now, Simon, before you eat the sweets, I'd like you to guess how many jelly beans are inside the jar.
Okay, got it.
What is it?
Oh. It's a bit slow here. 2,500.
2,500. Would you be impressed if I told you that you've guessed right?
Yeah.
That's impossible, isn't it?
Literally impossible.
Could you please remove the lid and read the note I placed inside before the show?
What? That is amazing.
Oh my God.
That is amazing. Bless him.
Oh. Wow.
That's unbelievable.
Earlier, I asked you to think of a playing card. Could you please remind everyone what that card was?
Seven of diamonds.
Seven of diamonds. Could you please remove the one face down card?
Yep. Got it.
Please show it to everyone.
Here we go. Unbelievably talented. Seriously.
I love him.
That absolutely freaked me out when I saw that. There's something really, really incredible about you. And I do believe in magic. And you're such an amazing performer.
Thank you.
You're brilliant. Brilliant.
Yes, you've made me and Alicia a mess. You were amazing.
Thank you.
I mean, absolutely phenomenal. Great showmanship. I'm really glad that magic has changed your life and given you so much confidence. But above all of that, you are a little superstar, so well done.
Thank you.
I loved everything about it, but especially love you, your passion, your personality. And it's clear to everyone just how much this means to you, which makes this extra special.
I was totally, totally captivated by what you were doing. And for somebody so young, it's an incredible quality. You have a fantastic future in front of you.
I agree.
Okay, we're gonna take a vote. Bruno.
Say yes for me!
Alicia.
Say yes!
If this world makes you crazy, you've taken all you can bear.
It's a yes from me!
You call me up.
Four yeses. You are genuinely, I think, one of the best magicians we've ever, ever had on our shows.
When Simon chose me to be on his dream team, I just couldn't believe it.
What I love about magic is that when I understand what the main story is,
yes,
I think it makes it more special.
It really does.
Yeah. So my one piece of advice is tell a story and use great music.
There's a lot of magic here tonight.
It is, yeah. Yes.
Us, Anna de Guzman.
Yeah. Like a lot of good magic, yes. Right?
Okay, here we go, guys, clearing stage.
There is a lot of great competition here, but I really do think I have a chance of winning. I'm gonna put up a good fight.
With words, we can paint the world with kindness and create magic in everyday moments. Simon, the last time we met, I asked you to think of a magic word, which you wrote down on this hanky. Your magic word, dog. I'll leave it here. Now, I know you hate card tricks, but yeah. Don't worry. It's not one of those. I've written some random words on the back of these cards. Take this half and mix them up whilst I mix these. If I hear
Howie, please, say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
Read whatever is written on the back, but don't let me see.
Okay.
Simon, in a world that's often upside down, there's a chance for fun and happy moments to pop up when we least expect them. Let's bring our two halves together as one, so we can find joy in this chaos. What if we could create a special moment of magic by making these mixed up words rearrange themselves to tell my story? Impossible, right? It's done. Forget what we're told. Simon, I'm here because of you.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Howie, I asked you to choose a card, which was the...
Nine of Spades.
The Nine of Spades. Let's try this. You know, Howie, only those who believe in magic can truly find it. Watch very, very, very closely. What was the word written on the back of the card that you chose?
Believe.
What? Now, Simon, show everyone what's written on the hanky.
Believe.
Changed.
My teacher, Mrs. Kirwan, always says, if you truly believe, then anything is possible. I used to be on the outside looking in, but now I'm on the inside looking out.
You know, this show, AGT and all the GTs around the world, are all about diversity. Anybody from any walk of life should be able to compete and have their dreams come true, including neurodiversity. And yeah, you are truly amazing, not only as a magician, but as a human being.
Thank you very much.
Heidi.
It was really, really great. It is a real show. And not just like a little act, like we could watch a whole show with you. Well done, young man.
Look, I've seen a lot of magic on the shows over the years, and I think you really, really have something special about you. You're 14 years old, and you've come all the way, thousands of miles, to come up with something so incredible. Just blew my mind. I really love you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hello.
It's a yes from me. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What happened to your tops?
We forgot them.
Oh, wonderful. So please tell us the name of your act.
Vardanyan Brothers.
So that's your surname and your brothers. How old are you boys?
28, 30 years.
Where are you from originally?
We are from Armenia, but we're living in Moscow.
Oh, well, I'm intrigued as what you're going to do. The stage is yours. Thank you.
I like how they look like they mean business.
Yeah. They look like sort of superheroes, actually, don't they?
Shop.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. What's got in his head?
No. No.
I almost was going to say, you can't do this, because in all my years, this is the most dangerous act I've ever seen on any Got Talent show.
It was a stunning stunning act, and I feel just so proud that you've come on to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you very much.
Oh, that was so thrilling. We were on the edge of our seats. It was incredible.
Exciting, dangerous, and I cannot wait to see what you're going to do next.
I genuinely meant what I said. It really is the most dangerous thing I've ever seen. Ever.
We have more difficult tricks as well, up our sleeve.
More difficult than that?
Can't have, it's impossible.
What?
Shut up, man.
Let's take a vote.
Let me start this off with a yes.
Thank you.
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
4 yeses, you are through to the next round.
Try this at home, y'all. Please. What is going on?
What did you think?
What you did, I thought it was okay. Up until you took the sword on sword, if you fall, your entire face
exactly.
is impaled.
Yeah.
That took it to a whole new level.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Simon?
I think, you know, because we had a not a dissimilar act earlier on who just had more levels.
But it's very different, those acts.
It is
acts.
Different.
I know.
Very different. They but didn't balance on swords.
Look, I think you are really, really, really talented. However, I think in this show, you've got to step it up from where you were before. I saw you on Britain's Got Talent, and I don't think that was a step up. But it's not down to me.
You won't see that anywhere else apart from on my team with those guys. So make sure you vote for them because they deserve it. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I don't think they'll go through.
Oh, don't be jealous now.
I'm
don't be nasty.
He looks Aiden. Like an Aiden. Are you Aiden? Nice to meet you, Aiden.
I love a curly whirly. When you dip it in a cup of tea and suck it all off.
No, you put it in the freezer first.
Oh yes, then it snaps.
I'm intrigued about the box, but I'm not going to ask.
Don't ask.
Go for it.
Over to you on the start.
Enjoy.
Hello.
Hi, Deck.
What's your name, darling?
Aiden McCann.
Where are you from?
I'm from Ireland.
Oh. Yes.
you?
I'm 10 years old.
What is it that you're going to be doing?
Today I'm... That's annoying. My shoelace is actually undone. That's better. Oh! Today I'm going to be doing some magic. I've been doing magic for 5 years. And I usually perform in front of my parents, my auntie Laura, who swears a lot.
Why does she swear?
Because she's so impressed. My big dream is to win the 250K, perform in front of the royal family. I've only performed like I'm doing today in front of my sister's teddies. She has like 200. I said, Molly, get all your teddies, it's time. Alicia,
hey.
I see that you've got a lot of nice rings there. Can I borrow that one, please?
This one? Okay.
Yeah, please. Perfect. Actually, you hold on to that for a minute.
Okay.
Right here, I actually have a handkerchief. There's nothing in it. I'll take the ring there. Now, I'm going to put it in the handkerchief. This. Perfect. If you can just hold on to your ring, please.
Okay.
Okay. Now, I'll just... It's over. Now, Alicia, you're holding on to your ring. You can still feel it, yes?
Yes.
Okay, watch. Hold it up nice and high. Okay, if I just grab it by the corners, it's vanished.
Wow. Where's it gone?
Okay, now, Simon, my mum told me that it's your birthday this year. You're turning 80, so I brought you a gift. If you would like to open up your gift, you can just take it out by the ribbon.
Okay.
Now you can undo the ribbon and open the box.
Thank you.
Watch. Watch, I got you a watch, Simon.
Oh, that's a very nice watch.
Okay, would you like to put out your left hand for me, please?
My left hand, okay.
Perfect. Now I'm going to unscrew the back of the watch. Just like that. Now in this watch is something very special.
Crazy.
Alicia, wow. Can you please take out what's in the watch?
Oh, my goodness!
Wow, that's very good.
Alicia, is that your ring?
That is my ring!
Now, Alicia, they say to never do the same trick twice, but today I feel like a rebel, so I'm going to break that rule.
Okay.
Can I please have your ring again?
Okay.
Let's get my magic wand. Okay, watch. It's vanished. Now, Alicia, there's been a lot of amazing magicians on Britain's Got Talent, and a lot of them have done sleight of hand, okay? But today I'm going to do something completely different.
Okay.
And I call this sleight of foot.
What?
Aidan, I was just completely mesmerised by you. I think that you, my little friend, are a star.
Thank you.
Aidan, at what age did you first go to Hogwarts School? You're very likeable. You have a huge talent. I think you could do very well in this competition this year, Aidan. We're going to vote.
Yes
for me. Aidan, that means you now have 4 yeses. Congratulations.
This is really great. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey everyone, it's great to be here. Simon.
Yes.
When you were a kid in the 1870s, did you have flashcards?
Aidan.
They sell me read.
And now they even help me read minds. I know, spooky. So, here they are, the 26 letters of the alphabet,
yep.
All with their own individual image. So, can you tell me when to stop, please, whenever you want?
Okay. Stop!
Oh, are you sure?
Yep.
All right, great. So take this card, don't look at it, and we'll get back to it in a second.
Thank you, Aidan.
Thank you. Heidi.
Yes?
I want you to look into my eyes. Ooh. Now, I do this to create a strong connection with the person. But in your case, I just wanted to look into your eyes. Heidi, you gave me the gift of the golden buzzer.
Yes.
So I brought you a gift.
Oh.
But you can't open it yet.
Okay.
We'll leave it right there.
Thank you.
Because in only one of those balloons, I have a prediction. A card that hopefully matches your card. And if you get it right, you can open your gift. And I'll need someone to help me on stage. Someone charming, charismatic, handsome, funny,
yes.
Known all around the world. So where are you, Terry? Come on out. Terry, as always, you're looking nearly as buff as me. Keep going to the gym, hang in there. You'll get these bad boys soon enough.
He's so funny.
Terry, I want you to hold on to these darts for me. So, Simon, you'll go first. Pick a balloon you don't think that my prediction's in.
Pink.
Pink. All right. Terry, throw the dart at the pink balloon.
All right.
Let's see. And you were right. Terry, no card. Howie, it's your turn now. I know, tough choice, they all look a lot like you, but try to pick a balloon. Pick a balloon you don't think my prediction is in.
Yellow.
Terry, pop the yellow balloon. You are right, no card. Heidi.
Yes.
No pressure. If you do this wrong, my trick is ruined and it will be a long flight back to Ireland. So, green or blue balloon, which one do you want Terry to pop?
Blue.
Terry, pop the blue balloon. Let's see. And you were all right. No card, which must mean my prediction's in this balloon. All right, here we go. Terry, can you hear this?
I can hear it.
That's my prediction. Pop the balloon. Look it, a card came out. Terry, show everyone what that card is.
It is...
an octopus. Simon, for the first time, show everyone what card you chose.
Yes!
It's an octopus. Thank you so much, Terry. Oh, you've been great.
Thank you.
Now, Heidi.
I can open it.
Well, since you got it right, you can open it. What's in there?
An octopus.
A purple octopus! Now, to prove that I knew it was octopus from the very beginning, everybody, look up! Everyone get a balloon! Judges, get a balloon! Everyone, hold up what's inside! Inside.
Oh my gosh!
I've been Aidan McGann! Who can? McGann can! Thank you and good night!
Aidan McKinn! Heidi, your golden buzzer!
Hey! I mean, you are as confident and as skilled as a grown magician. You really are, but it's just much cuter when you do it. It really is. We're gonna get this all the way. Why not? Let's win this thing! That was so good!
Simon!
Yeah, I just think you need a bit more confidence. No, that was actually quite amazing. You've got an amazing personality. I mean, honestly, incredible. Everyone tonight has been fantastic.
I agree.
Thank you.
Howie.
Yeah, I agree with what my fellow judges said. The magic was impeccable.
and you have such a stage presence. You're a great comedian, you're a great performer, and you're a great magician, and most of all, you're an all-star.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Aiden. Aiden has done all he can. It's now up to the super fans to decide if he should be our All-Stars champion. We'll get the result in next week's finale. For now, make some noise for Aiden McCann.
Thanks for my present.
Thank you. Bye, guys. Thank you.
He's just adorable.
It's one thing to remember the magic, but how does he remember all those jokes? And when things happen, he thinks on his feet. He's
Come on, let's go!
excited.
Ichikawa, congratulations.
Thank you.
There's no other place for you, really, than this show.
I can assure you one thing, it's not fake, it's real.
I am literally speechless. It's like an out-of-body experience.
Listen, one series on this show, that will become normal.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe that I enjoyed that. I actually really enjoyed it.
What I'm most looking forward to is potentially saying, Your Royal Highness King Charles, may we proudly present the winner of Britain's Got Talent. We're going to take a vote, Ichikawa. It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Alicia.
I enjoyed that, but I don't ever want to see it again.
What?
You want to see it again? Okay, for the potential, it's a yes.
Thank you!
Bruno.
Oh, it's a no for me.
But it's a no. I mean, here we go.
Simon.
Well, I didn't know what was going on. I genuinely hadn't got a clue. And then I understood. I remember watching Rocky for the first time, thinking one of the most suspenseful, exciting end of a movie I've ever seen, and that was up there. I've never wanted a balloon to burst so much in my life. Take that buzzer away. By the wind beneath my wings. I'm thrilled to give you your third yes.
Now, I watched something that you watched and judged on BGT this year. One of the most viral moments, because I looked at the numbers. I think this is inspirational. I think this is motivational. I think this is going to blow you all away.
Okay.
My name is Ichikawa. I'm 43. I'm from Japan. And I'm a semi-finalist on Britain's Got Talent.
I'm a wind musician.
A wind musician?
Yeah.
BGT, the first stage I was on, I was most nervous and most excited.
I didn't know what was going on, and then I understood.
Finally, Simon and I were hugging. I came out with tears. I challenged. That was the semi-final.
Ichikawa, you are going home.
もう無気力状態でそういう気持ちになってしまいました。失意のどん底で日本で暮らしていました。そしたらある日電話が鳴ったんです。Ichikawa。Hi.
Hi. I'm Howie.
Howie, yeah.
What you do is going to leave America in awe.
America? Can I go to America?
Yeah, you're coming to America.
Whoa!
Second chance.
Ichi. To have a gift like you have, it's not a talent that we have ever had on our stage before. When you go out there, just don't be nervous, just let it go.
ありがとう! Thank you!
next performance is Soap Bubbles.
Soap Bubbles. No. Simon, no. Simon, go
no.
on up.
No, 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 no.
Simon,
no.
Simon.
No, Pina.
It's your act.
Your Mel. Act. You're the mentor.
Mel.
Howie.
Howie.
Heidi.
Howie. Howie.
I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it.
Thank you. Please come here, please. Howie, glasses.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What's he gonna do with the big balloon?
Sit, please.
All right.
And wear helmet, okay?
All right, safety first.
Yeah.
All right. Please, everybody.
Howie!
Ishikawa!
Don't move!
That's a dart.
Oh. Oh. Oh, no.
Young man, put the F in artistry. You can win $250,000 with that talent. Heidi.
It didn't stink.
No, sir, ma'am.
I've seen you online. You've blown candles out before on a birthday cake. But this, dangerous.
Heidi, no birthday cake. You got to take
Heidi, we will be at your birthday anytime you want. He can help blow out the candles.
Good idea.
I'm glad nobody lit a match.
Mel.
No.
Oh.
Just a moment, please. Just a moment, please.
Wait. This is for you, Mel.
Present for you.
Oh.
Oh, hell no.
Look, I always like acts that are the best at what they do
right
in the world. Is there anyone who does that better in the world? Arguably, no.
What is wrong with
well,
you
I'm
all?
Just saying.
This is disgusting.
Well, it's not easy. All right, thank you very much again.
We didn't do that. We didn't do that. Did you like it?
No!
Hi.
Hello.
Do you want to tell us who you are, please?
Mandy Mewden.
And where are you from?
London.
All right. Mandy, how old are you?
Let's just say I've seen a few summers and leave it there, Simon.
That's a good answer. We've all seen a few summers, Mandy. Is this what you do full time?
Yeah, I'm a bit of a performer.
Have you nearly had that opportunity where you had that break?
To be quite honest, not really, because my family don't even really know who I am, so no.
They don't know who you are.
No, they're always confused when I come home, but, you know. I keep trying, you never know.
All right, well, look, good luck.
Thank you very much.
It's just right up my street. It's fun.
OK, now, I'm going to show you something that is a little bit extraordinary, OK? whatever I write or draw on this pad becomes a reality.
What? I was hoping I'd be a bit older when the melons dropped. Now, I'm completely psychiatric, psychotic, and some people do actually call me a witch. And David, I'm being very drawn to you. Can you feel me stroking your aura? You will in a minute. Now, David, I'm going to try and read your mind. I want you to think of somebody, David, that you're very, very attracted to. Who is it, David, that you're very, very attracted to?
Simon!
That's interesting. Now, Alicia, I'm being drawn to you, and I want you to think of something you like to do most days. All right, here we go. All right, what are you thinking of?
Food.
She's brilliant, this girl.
I love her.
Right, Simon, because it's you, dear, I want you to think of a number between 1 and 5,000. Make it really hard for me, all right? Here we go, Simon. Are you thinking? OK, this'll be it. What number were you thinking of?
777.
That is uncanny. Amanda.
Yeah?
Would you be so kind as to join me on stage?
Amanda,
doesn't she look gorgeous? To sit on that stool. Now, Amanda, just touch any card you like. Yes, touch any card. Take it out. Look at it. Okay, I'm going to make a prediction of what it is. Show everybody and remember it. Okay. Just to say, David, you're very attracted to Simon, and I don't blame you with that lovely jawline. Alicia, you like food?
What?
And your number was 777. Was that right, Simon?
Yes.
But that says 770.
Oh, maybe I got that one wrong, but let's move on. OK. Sometimes witches can't be perfect. Now, Amanda,
yes.
What was the card?
It was the Four of Spades.
The Four of... Was it?
Yes.
Not the three?
No, it was a four.
So we're a spade missing then, everybody. OK, well, look, here it is.
I think she was really good.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you, beautiful girl?
I'm Mandy Muden. I'm from London in the United Kingdom.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
Oh.
It's been a rough couple of years, you know what I mean?
And what do you do, Mandy?
I do magic.
Why AGT? Now?
Well, being British, as Simon will back me up to say, I love America. Also, I owe money and had to get out of the UK.
What are you going to do with $1 million if you win?
Well, I do. I'd probably spend it on men.
On men? Okay, we're ready for you. We want to see your magic.
Okay, fantastic. Right, everybody, are you ready to get into a magic mood? Okay, America's Got Talent. Look at this. Four strangers ready to judge me. It's like one of those parties where you throw the car keys into the fishbowl. Heidi,
yes?
Would you just... I've got a bag here
full
of letters. Could you just reach in and get a few out just to make sure that they're all different? It's very difficult with the gloves on, isn't it? If you just committed a crime and hoping to get away with it.
They all look different.
Lovely. Shove that back. I'll give the bag a bit of a shake. Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I want you just to take a letter
One?
Don't look at it.
Okay.
Okay, fantastic. Could you take one as well?
Take it out?
Yes, please, and don't look at it. We'll come back to that later. Okay, Sophia, could you do the same? Okay, fantastic. Now, Simon, I'm going to riffle through my book. Could you just stick anything in you like?
Finger?
Yes, a finger would be lovely, Simon. Okay, brilliant. Now, Simon, could you look at the page number?
Yes.
And the first word on the page, Simon.
Got it.
Okay, and could you write them down and remember them?
Yes, I can.
Okay, fantastic. I'm just going to pop back up to the stage. Feel free to check me out, Simon. Okay. Right, here we go. Now, Howie, I want you to think of any word at all in the English language.
Okay.
Now, would you be impressed if the word you were thinking of was written on a piece of paper in the bag in front of you?
Yes, more than impressed.
Please open the bag.
It's a dictionary.
Unbelievable. Heidi and Sophia, open your packages. Okay, Heidi, what lovely love story do you have, Heidi?
Mine says 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, now, Simon, what page were you on?
70.
Okay, Heidi, could you turn to page 70? I'm just going to go into a trance and read your mind. Here we go. Page 70. Does your word begin with an F?
Yes.
Right, lovely. Now, are you familiar with this word?
Yes, I'm familiar with the word.
Okay. Now, the spirits are telling me that this word ends in I-N-G. Okay. Have you done this word today?
Yes.
That's my girl. Fantastic. Is your word, by any chance, is it fantasizing?
Yes, it is.
Okay, now, Sophia, could you go to 70? Could you look at the last word on page 70, Sophia?
I don't have my glasses. 70.
Okay, Howie, you've got a dictionary there.
Yes.
Could you go to page 330?
Okay.
And could you go down 7 word entries?
7 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's the word?
Loony.
No! It's loony.
Now, Simon, you were thinking of a word, you wrote it down. What was your word?
Eat.
Eat. Howie, you picked a letter.
Could
you
I did.
Hold your letter up and shout it out?
It's an E.
An E. E. What do you have there, Heidi?
I have an A.
And what do you have, Sophia?
A T.
Unbelievable! Thank you so much!
Bravo!
Oh, wow, thank you so much. Thank you.
Mandy, that was quite a surprise.
Oh.
You're so funny, and I didn't expect to have so much fun. Howie?
You're a very good magician. You're funny. I love you. I'm a huge fan of yours. You are the epitome of somebody that deserves to have their own show. I would go see you in Las Vegas.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Heidi!
I think that you are adorable. And can I keep this?
Yes, of course.
Simon.
We saw everything, didn't we? I mean, you were mind reading, you were funny, you were very naughty. I really like you.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
So we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It's a yes from me, for Mandy.
Oh, thank you so
Simon.
Much.
Simon.
It's a yes.
Howie.
3 yeses.
Oh, 4 yeses.
That was amazing. I couldn't believe what Howie said. It was like, he's such a hero of mine. I was like, oh my God.
She is great.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Celebrate.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening, Britain's Got Talent.
We have prepared something very special just for you tonight.
In preparation for this, Emily started up on the UK. So let's see how well she's tuned into your culture. Therefore, she will be blindfolded. And Stephen, can we have you on stage? Give it up for Stephen, everybody.
Hey, yeah.
Just do me a favor. You cannot see through it, right?
Nothing at all.
There are no flat screens inside, no loudspeakers.
Nope.
Thank you so much, Stephen.
Very thorough. Well done. Give it up for Stephen.
Oh, thank you, Stephen. Okay, I'm going to blindfold you. And if you don't mind, I will join your judges, yes. Okay? Hello.
Hello,
hello everyone. Pen.
Sure.
I have an envelope for you.
Okay.
We'll leave it in front of you. We'll need it a little bit later, okay?
Good.
And here I have postcards with unique things about the UK. Can you just read out some,
yeah,
whatever
Lewis
you see?
Yeah, Lewis Hamilton scones, Adele.
What do we have here?
Wellington, yeah.
Okay, you get the idea, they're all different. Amanda, yes, will start with you. I go through the postcards, just put your finger on one, whatever you like. This one? Take it, yes, take it. Hold on to it. Alicia, same for you, I go through the cards. Here, okay, point to a card, whatever you like. Anyone?
This one,
this
please.
One, sure. Take your card,
thank
okay?
Thank you.
And last but least, David, here, any card, whatever you like. I will look away, just peek at them so you know what's on there. You know what it is, everybody?
Yep. Yes.
So, Emily, are you ready to go into the minds of the judges?
Yes. Okay, I'm starting with Amanda.
Amanda.
I want you to think of the choice you made. Oh, I get the feeling you're thinking of a landmark.
Yes.
But you're not in London. You traveled outside of London, like, I'd say 2 hours. And in your mind, you're standing in front of Stonehenge.
Show us the
yes!
card. Is it?
Stonehenge!
Okay, let's go on with Alicia.
Alicia?
Your thoughts are very strong. I do believe it is food. And it's very warm, delicious, and crispy. Alicia, you're thinking of fish and chips.
I am.
Fish and chips, everyone.
Wow.
And now to you, David. Huh, it's interesting because I do believe you're listening to music. It's the male voice. You're thinking of Ed Sheeran.
David, for the first time.
I am thinking of Ed Sheeran.
It is Ed Sheeran.
Ken, you have been holding onto this envelope the entire time, right?
Guarding it with my life.
Thank you for doing this. I will take it for the very first time because now.
Okay.
No, this is going to be interactive with everybody. Here inside is a QR code. The QR code will get you to our profile and there, we posted the reel on October 9th, the day we left Las Vegas.
Scan the code and play the video.
Hello, everybody. We just finished 1 year here in beautiful Las Vegas, and it was amazing.
And now we're off to the UK. I can't wait to see all the sites like Stonehenge.
Oh, Stonehenge, that's beautiful. I'm already in the mood. That's why I got myself some fish and chips.
Yummy. Las Vegas, we'll be back.
See you in the United Kingdom. And have a very close look on her shirt. There it is, Ed Sheeran! Thank you!
But you know what? Tonight we'll try the ultimate challenge.
You just saw Emily blindfolded, but now let's totally isolate her. Ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time in the United Kingdom, mind reading under water. Have a very close look, a tank filled with 400 gallons of water, 360 degrees around, nothing below, nothing above, crystal clear. And now we need something from all of you. I need to borrow some cash. If you have some money, take it out, hold it up high into the air, and Pen, You walk into the audience wherever you want to go and borrow us a note. And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back on stage, Amelie Fantas. So, okay, Ben, okay. It's in your fist, okay?
Yes, it is.
Ben, you are the eyes of the audience. You
make
sure that everything is fair. And I will tell you what will happen in just a moment.
Okay.
In a moment, Amelie will get inside the tank. Everybody knows that every single banknote has a own unique serial number. And that's exactly what she wants to write down underwater with her lipstick. The serial number on the bill in your hand. Amelie, are you ready to do this? Hand me the bill. She's writing down. Pen, can you read the first two letters?
A, D.
A, D. Now she's writing down the numbers. Pen, can you do me a favor?
Sure.
Can you confirm that the serial number on your bill is AD01525795?
Yes.
Look what she wrote. AD01525795. Welcome to our Las Vegas party suite. If I look around, it looks like we had a crazy night last night.
Yeah, because we celebrated a very special day, May 31st, 2016.
The date of our very first audition on America's Got Talent. And thinking about it, it just feels like it was yesterday.
Speaking of yesterday, I have no memory of what happened at last night's party. Do you, judges?
No.
Okay. Amelie will try to reach into your minds to find out what we did last night.
I have to put on this blindfold because that helps me get focused.
Simon, there are a bunch of different VIP cards and lanyards from Vegas attractions. We want to keep things random, so just take one of the strings, anyone you like.
Okay.
Yes, take it. Don't say what it is, just look what you've selected.
Oh, God.
Cover it with your hands. Concentrate on it and send your thoughts to Amelie.
Yes, I remember now, Simon. You insisted on going to this very special show, and that one was called Vegas Dark Divas.
Vegas Dark Divas.
It is Vegas Dark Divas.
Wow. Great dark.
And Mel B, I kind of have the feeling we had something to eat last night. At least, that would explain all these menus on the table, like here, burgers, Thai, steakhouse.
Yeah.
Just make it random. Just point to any menu, anyone, whatever you like.
Check it out.
Yeah. Select one of the food options on there. Howie, come a little bit closer.
Okay.
Show Howie and myself, just with your finger, what you have selected. This?
Okay.
Don't say it. Amelie?
Okay, Melby, I think you went kind of for a breakfast. I guess something like fruits. You went for the raspberry yogurt parfait.
Yes, raspberry yogurt parfait.
It is.
I saw that.
Yeah.
Howie,
what?
You see all these room keys on the table.
Okay.
Confirm, all room numbers are different, right?
It seems that way, yes.
2129. Let's take some, put them inside here. I will look away, reach inside, and just take one room key, not two. You have one.
I've got one.
Hold it against your body.
Howie.
What?
A pretty clear picture comes into my mind. Because yesterday night, we were walking around the casino, and you were wearing a bathrobe.
I was?
Oh, there's Howie's bathrobe. And Heidi, can you do me a favor? Can you read out loud what it says inside?
Do not remove from room 120.
Howie, for the first time, what room have you picked?
No.
120.
It is room 120! Here, you get your rope back. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But wait a second. All the random selections you made are associated to numbers. Mel B, let us know what is the name of the restaurant you picked.
Cafe 53.
Howie's room is 120. And Simon, can I have a look?
You may.
You're sitting in row 1, seat 6. Because Heidi, I remember you did heavy gambling last night and you won. Can you remember?
No.
You no. can't, but oh. Heidi, I do have the proof because you won $53,120.16.
Like Mel B's Cafe, Howie's Room, and Simon's Row and Seat. Oh, we got all the numbers. I'm so sorry, Heidi. We already spent all that money what? On this. Everybody, stand up. Try and catch a bill.
Because on the bills, you will see the faces of the judges. Mel B's Holding, her menu from Cafe 53.
Howie has his room number 120.
Oh, and Simon Holding his show tickets, row 1, seat 6.
How's that possible?
That's insane.
There is a reason this all happened.
It all started on one day, May 31st, 2016. You remember? The day of our audition?
Yes.
Everyone, have a close look or on this check.
May 31st, 2016. Thank you so much.
Thank you, America. Thank you, judges.
Thank you.
Try to make my way to the ordinary.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, sweetie. Are you ready?
I'm on standby, ready for the flight.
Good luck, my love. I believe in you. I remember how it all started.
Hi, Mom. I'm back.
Emotional artistry we just witnessed.
Yeah.
Heidi, what do you think?
It's amazing how you create emotions with sand.
Thank you.
And how one morphs into the next piece of art. You are an amazing artist.
Thank you, Heidi.
Yeah.
Mel.
I don't know, I was a bit lost at one point. But there's no denying that what you do is spectacular. It just didn't get me like it has done before. And I've seen you do your act before.
I tell you what is amazing about your act. No one else in the world can do what you can do. No one. And you never know what the story is going to be or what's going to happen next. I mean, it's incredible.
Thank you, Simon.
With this particular show, it's really not up to us whether you move on. But I am so glad that you are part of my squad, and I think you're gonna move on.
don't know what she's drinking. Let me just see what it is.
It's water!
Uh-oh.
It's water, yep, that I can use to throw on you.